you guys were there. Thank you for coming back.
Sorry I've been neglecting you guys, but things have changed here in Wildebeest Garage. Been working on some things that I've promised you guys, and you guys have been following through. As far as last time I checked, we were at 1,600 views, and I said that I would start getting together a hat. Well, as you can see, I don't have the hat on. It's being produced right now, so if you guys keep it up, I will start getting those hats coming. Now, the next step is to get everybody to start liking the stuff. Soon enough, I'd like to replace this Tesla wall. Yes, I know. I like it too, but we need to get a banner going up for Wildebeest Garage. Just think how cool that would be to have Wildebeest Garage sitting right there. See if I could put a little thing image right there, so then that way when I come out here you guys will see nothing but Wildebeest Garage as a banner. I think that'd be pretty cool. So I need to get everybody to like all the videos that I've posted. In order for that to happen, I am working on getting a website set up so that here, maybe next year, depends on how well you guys come up with likes and comments and everything like that, telling your friends, family, neighbors, coworkers about my videos, maybe we can set up a website where you guys can go buy Wildebeest Garage memorabilia, merchandise, whatever you want to call it. So this time, today, what I'm going to be doing is we're going to be taking apart the rear end. Now, let me show you what I got while I've been gone, or while I haven't been posting videos, because I know a lot of you guys don't like the weld and grind and cut and splice and everything like that. You guys think it's boring. Yes, I agree, but it needs to be done. So let me show you what we got. So last video that I posted before, you know, the demo or the review and the Good Guys Car Show, which was excellent, but I had finished up this right here. Now here's the other side of it. So we're getting progress. Today we're going to be working on the rear end, getting that all cleaned up. And we need to take out these tabs right here, gusset them. We also need to gusset the frame where I shortened it. Right now, as you guys saw, that I was taking the control arms apart. Got to take that out, got to take the differential out, and then we'll get up in there and we'll start going from there. But I do want to say I appreciate you guys watching very much. It helps out a lot. Helps me know that, you know, some people are interested in this build and what it takes. You guys are interested in what I'm doing on a daily basis. So a little bit of background, what I've been doing is doing a lot of sports with my boys. As some of you guys know, my boys are heavily into baseball, and as a parent, it takes a lot to support your kids in what they want to do. And so here I am back to the 64 progress, and let's see what we can get done.
Like I said, first of all, I'm going to be jacking this up. So we're going to take the rim spares off, control arms. So let's get up on Jackson's first. take this, actually, let's take that off. That's fine. It'll be fine. Okay, I already took these bolts loose so we can pull this out. Now, one of these days I'm gonna paint all this stuff. Not the calipers, well, we'll probably paint the calipers, but not the rotors. Some of you guys like to do that. I don't know why, but they do. Deal of trust. A little bit of luber duber on this situation. Alright, well, let's do this other side then. This other space you're taking off. Down just to here. Oh boy. Alright. Let's take these spindles off and see what we got. First, before we do that, let's take this off and see what we can get, and I'll bring you in. moving.
You shouldn't have done that.
Okay. Oh, you can take this bolt off right here. Take this other one off. I know that just seemed a little contradictory, ironic, but I was using an electric to hold a bolt steady as I took the rest of this apart. Hey, it worked. Was it a dumb idea if it worked? I don't think so. Pull these bolts out. I will be painting these control arms. And the subframe. Painting all that. Make it look a lot better than what it is. Figure out how this works. Okay. Do this. Oh, okay. So before I take, let me show you. Come on down here. Before I take this bolt out, I gotta measure it or make this so we can realign it the way it is. So what I think I'm gonna do is line this up with the file. It's going to be hard to mark it with like a paint marker when it's all going to be sandblasted and you won't be able to see the mark. So I think if I put a little chinger in the frame, if I can get it deep enough, that, you guys see that? Let's see. Yeah, it'll work. We're gonna do the other side too, like that. And while I got you over there,
oh no, I
fell. Why'd you fall? Is it that boring already? We'll get you back up. Come on, stop your drinking, let's go, time to work. All right, let's see. Pull you up a little bit. There you go. Is that better? Yeah, I know. You're welcome. So I'm gonna do the same thing here. See if I can get it. Lined up. I know the guys that I do the go with for the alignment, they're gonna have to move around and tweak this, and you know, that'll be fun. But at least this way, it'll be pretty close.
That's good.
Get you over here. These were the bolts that I was undoing on the other side. So now I'm gonna do it on this side. safety first. Head was too big on the other ratchet. Yep, I know. Rose, you might not believe me, but size does matter. No matter what you try to tell your guy. Now, we're going to take up the control arm off. Oh. Didn't expect that. You guys see that? Oh, no, you've fallen asleep. Watch this. We have a cam bolt. Show you what a cam bolt looks like once I get this off.
So this is the bolt right here. This wedges into here, like that. Now depending on where you rotate, this allows it to rotate like a cam. There's a cam lobe right here, and it's off-centered. Allows you to get the different camber that you want. You want to do cambered in and wear the inside of your tires like crazy. You just rotate that. All right, here on the other side, keep you guys informed, entertained. Yeah, I should have marked it again, but oh well. I'll get to where the tires are standing up straight, and I'll take it over to my buddy and have him work his magic. This one free. Going a lot easier second time. Imagine that. That was a lot easier the second time. Gives me more time to be with you guys. Let's do this one. Let's see what the transmission's at, a little bit safer. No.
ago. Fixed it. Electrical tape won't fix it, nothing will.
All right, so we got the, oh man, my face is dirty. I didn't do anything and my face is dirty. Well, now you know how my mom feels. So anyways, down. So we took that out, differential out. There's a stack of parts. You don't want to see that. So next step, we're gonna take this. We're gonna cut this off right here. But what I do want to do is flip this over so I could see a little bit better what we're going to do and how we're going to do it before we do that. So we're going to do a little fast play of me dropping this down, or maybe I'll just cut this out because it is kind of boring. So here we go. Change the plans. I'm gonna actually cut this tab off right here. Cut this tab off right here, and we'll flip it around the other way, and hopefully we can actually make a progress or an actual motion in the turning. Because that tab right there is stopping it, and this tab over here is stopping it. So I'm thinking if I delete this, it'll actually allow it to roll over. We're gonna go with that. Toes.
There we have it. All right. Let's get back to flipping this.
After grinding and the camera cutting off so many times, let me show you what I got. So the weld's grounded down on this side, and here's the seam of where I cut it. I welded on the outside because it's easier to get to. So now my weld on the inside, I'm going to grind that down. I'm going to put a gusset in here to reinforce it and make it stronger. So here we go.
Well, I don't know why the camera keeps dying, but let me show you what I've got so far. Got this ground down, got the plate that I'm gonna make out of a gusset marked, and just realized that the camera died. That's as far as I'm gonna get. I gotta figure out why my camera's dying. That or I gotta buy a new one. So until then, thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe. If you haven't subscribed, please subscribe. If you're subscribed, great. Please leave a comment on what you like, what I can do better, what you don't like. So if you haven't liked it, please like. Please go back and review and like all the other videos. It'll help grow the channel faster, and it'll pretty much make it so that I can stop doing side job for side money and be able to continue on this project without having to do side jobs. So until then, thank you for watching. Remember, as always, get out there and do something. Doesn't matter what it is, just get out there and do something. And so far, I've been working on this, grinding and welding and grinding and welding. So if you guys like that stuff, please like and comment. If you guys don't like it, please comment. Tell me what else I can do. If I need to do it after the video, if I need to do it on my own time and not your time, please let me know. As always, thank you for watching. I appreciate it. And I'll see you guys on the next video.